In this video, I'm going to teach you about audio editing in Corel's VideoStudio. I'll show you how to work with audio from video, add sound effects, background music, and more. First, add your video to the timeline. You can quickly see if the video contains audio, as there will be an audio icon on top of the track on the left side of the clip. To see audio waves, press the sound mixer icon in the middle toolbar. To mute a clip, right-click and then click Mute. The audio icon will now be red, which indicates it has been muted. To mute the whole track, go to the left side of the track and press the sound icon. If you would like to split the audio to its own track, right-click on the clip and select Split Audio. This will separate the audio to its own track, and from here you can delete it, move it on the timeline, or manage the audio independent of the video. After splitting the audio from video, the video track will be muted by default. Now that you've removed the audio from your video, why not add a soundtrack or a sound effect? Go into Auto Music from the middle toolbar. This is the Score Fitter Music Library. Here you can preview different tracks and add them to your timeline. They will even auto-fit to your timeline, and the length of the music will match the length of your clip. These tracks are all royalty-free and can be used for personal or commercial use. To fade in or fade out music, double-click on the media in the timeline, either the video with audio or the audio track, and select the icons Fade In and also Fade Out. Alternatively, you can right-click on the track and select these options too. If you click on the sound mixer icon again, you can see how this changes the audio waves on the timeline. You can further adjust the fading in and out of the music by clicking on the line and adding other keyframes to make further adjustments. By extending and adjusting these keyframes, I've just created a more gradual fading out. Now, if you're layering audio, perhaps creating a video and have both a voiceover and background music, VideoStudio has a great tool called audio ducking. It will automatically lower the track when audio is identified. Here, I have a video and I want to add a voiceover and some background music. So I've added the voiceover on the voice track and some background music on the music track. Now, I will right-click on the music track and select Audio Ducking. Then select OK. You'll hear that the background music is lowered automatically where the voice track is playing. There's no one quite like your big sister. Someone who listens to you, laughs with you, and loves you unconditionally. From here, you can make any adjustments you like by adjusting the keyframes. Lastly, when working with a recorded audio clip, VideoStudio provides some audio tools. Right-click on the audio clip you want to edit and go to Audio Filters. Here, you can add various effects or remove noise to help clean up your audio. I'm going to play with some fun echo effects. You can see how adding different audio filters will change how the audio sounds. Additionally, if you have various audio tracks recorded that you are going to combine in your video, you will want to normalize the audio so that the volume level is consistent throughout. To do that, highlight all the tracks by holding Shift and clicking on each clip. Then right-click on the track and select Normalize Audio to adjust all tracks to the same volume level.